Greetings from Stary Saltov, a small town resort not far from Kharkov, Ukraine. You have seen me already driving a car around Kharkov, Ukraine, and this time I will be driving a motorboat around Stary Saltov River. We have tried to find a good location to actually park the car and to film the video for you, but the water and other water vehicles were messing with the sound, were messing with our lighting all the time, and my dear beloved husband has a crazy idea to film the video while driving a boat. I hope you will enjoy this format, and I hope I won't endanger myself, my husband, or the boat. Anyway guys, today we will speak about romance. It only sounds logical to discuss romance while observing such a beautiful sunset and driving the motorboat. When people choose international dating for all the right reasons, they choose it first of all because they want to experience this romantic adventure. They want not only to meet someone special, but to travel overseas, to get acquainted with a new culture, to experience this romantic adventure, to have the story that they will share with their kids or their future wedding, when they will tell people that, oh, I had to cross the ocean to actually meet my beloved Tatiana or my beloved Helena. So traveling and getting acquainted with a new culture is a huge part of the appeal. And so often when the gentleman travels over to, let's say, Kharkov, and he goes out on dates, his level of expectations, of romantic expectations, are very high. Of course, for the lady, her expectations regarding the date with a foreign gentleman are higher than expectations regarding the date with someone local, because, well, he's traveling like for 6, for 12, sometimes for 20 hours to meet me, so of course it's more of a special date than just going out with someone you have just met at the coffee shop. But many gentlemen often forget it. For a gentleman, for example, his romantic adventure starts the moment he boards the plane. He's on a vacation, he's not going to work, and all his attention, if he's doing everything right, will be focused on his romantic experience, on meeting the lady, on going out on dates. And after a fantastic date with the lady, when he returns back to the hotel room, pretty much he will be thinking only about the date, about this experience, and he will romanticize it even more. But for a lady, she's still in her country, of course she goes on a date and it's a magnificent, it's an extraordinary experience, but she returns back home. She returns back home to her kids if she has any, or to her cat, or to her every evening routine, to her usual routine. And the next day, guess what, she will go to work or she will go to her gym. So she's not on the same page romantically as a gentleman is. I have seen it so many times when, for example, a gentleman during his trip to Ukraine has 3-4 dates with a lady, and in his heart he's overwhelmed with his experience, he's in the new country and his focus is only on his dates, on the lady, and deep inside his heart he decided, wow, she is the one, because she is overwhelmed with this romance. But the lady, she also had the 3-4 dates with him, but she's still in her home country, in her home city, and the experience for her is not so overwhelming as for him. So her romantic adventure is developing on a different speed, and this is why we often recommend for the second meeting, for the second time with the gentleman plans to travel over to meet the lady again, to meet in the neutral territory, to go somewhere neutral, to a new city, maybe to a new country, so that you both are on the same page. You both are tourists in the new country, in the new city, and you spend literally 24/7 together, even if you are staying in different hotel rooms. Because for her, it will also be a romantic vacation just like for you. And she will be focusing only on you and how she feels on dates with you. Basically, it will be like, oh, what he said, what I said, how I felt. Because in her home city, when you date her in her home city for the first time, you return back to the hotel, and for you, this romantic process, it continues. You keep thinking about her. And she returns back home and she starts thinking what she will cook for breakfast or whether she has to finish a report at work. So pretty much your romantic attachment will develop on a different speed. After you return back home to your country, it will be like a roller coaster for you. You will miss this romance, you will miss this intense experience. Just like in every vacation, you will think only of all the positive sides, and she will be slightly on a different page with you because she didn't cross the ocean, she hasn't experienced a new culture. Yes, she has met a fantastic, extraordinary man, and it was a different new experience for her, but her level of romance, of adventure would be different than yours. So my advice to you would be, try not to be very hard on yourself and try to control your expectations, because so often you bring them on such a high level that it is not humanly possible to reach it, even if the dates go well. I will tell you a story really quickly. One of our clients who has managed to actually travel to Ukraine in between these lockdowns and stuff, he had several wonderful dates, and of course for him it was a huge adventure to travel to meet the lady, and with this lockdown his tickets were cancelled and he had to reschedule. So finally, when he has managed to land in Kharkov, Ukraine, and to go on dates, he felt like he has already killed the dragon, he has achieved this trip. And the dates went well, the lady really liked him. So after the gentleman returned back home, he was filled with this romance, with this feeling of adventure. It was like in his blood, and he has started writing this lady romantic letters, like filled with love and filled with anticipation, with longing. And she was not on the same page with him. Like, she likes him, but she is not in love with him after just 4 or 5 dates. So for her, letters that are too filled with romance, they are nice. She likes them, of course, and she feels flattered, but she's not on the same page yet to answer with the same passion, because she didn't cross the ocean, because she didn't kill the dragon yet. So maybe she will get there after she spends more time with the gentleman, or for example, if she had a similar experience, flying to another country, meeting him there, and concentrating 24/7 her attention on him. Guys, I hope you have managed to enjoy the view of the river behind me, and I hope that you can hear me, that the mic is doing the job. Thank you so much for watching us. We are doing videos with dating tips for you for 5 years already. Thank you for being with us. Svetlana Mukha from Diolli. This love.